हेलो हाय नमस्कार गुड मॉर्निंग होप यू ऑल आर फाइन हेल्दी एंड सेफ एट होम आई ऑल्सो होप द सेम एंड बेस्ट ऑफ दैट फॉर योर फैमिली मेंबर्स ओके फ्रेंड्स नाउ लेट अस बी प्रोडक्टिव एज वेल टू लुक फॉरवर्ड फॉर द अपकमिंग इंटरव्यूज दैट यू आर गोइंग टू फेस सो वील बी लर्निंग समथिंग अबाउट स्पेसिफिक A few interview tips that will help you to face the interview. So yeah, that's what am I, Dr. Ashok Mangaraj, and I represent today Vanik Institute, Bhubaneswar, that is bringing you all this information that is going to boost your career to a greater height. Let us begin. This is how it happens. So it is all about employment communication. Communication made to gain an employment, a position in an organization that you and me aspire for. So overall it is communication between a sender and a receiver with a definite purpose. That is what I mean. And communication has to be effective. You need to be impressing the board, the panel, so that they see you the best fit for what they're searching for. So that is what it is. And communication, the very essence is to develop a common understanding. What I say and what you see or understand should be proper. Should be both ways. They should be convinced about your candidature for the post that you are applied for, trying for. So here, specifically, we are in a mode that is extempore speech. Because when you appear before the board, they are free to ask you anything, from your shoes to satellite. Anything, they are free. And when they pose a question before you, you need to impress them. You need to be making a good impression. And that is out of instant, or it's called an extempore speech, with minimum or no preparation. Question to question, you may get hardly a minute or a fraction of a minute to think and frame your answer. And of course, with that, you need to impress. Not one who questions you, but the entire board. So it is more of a preparation and practice that will help you out. And of course, this is what I show you here. God has given us a wonderful instrument, mouth, that we speak and talk in a verbal and language that you use to communicate also matters. Moreover, your body language, your expressions, your gestures, your posture, the overall non-verbal sense of communication matters more than that. So let me focus what I was showing you, this piece of picture here, your mouth. This is what they say, iske andar jo jata hai, wo mujhe banata hai. If I take a lot of fast food, junk food, then I'll be fat, fat and fatter, day by day. The more important is the second phrase, कि इससे बाहर जो निकलता है वो मेरा तकदीर बनाता है सो दैट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल एंड वेरी स्ट्रैटेजिक व्हेन यू कम्युनिकेट एंड स्पेशली व्हेन यू कम्युनिकेट टू अ बोर्ड टू अ पैनल हु इज सिटिंग टू सिलेक्ट यू एज द बेस्ट फिट सो कम्युनिकेशन मैटर्स अ लॉट एंड स्पेशली वील डील विथ employment communication, the communication that you are supposed to get into when you face the board. So this is what they say, the predictors of success. There are three aspects of three things to that. IQ, you understand your intelligence. EQ, it is 70%, more than 70% of a person's success. And of course, AQ, the adversity quotient that they say. And especially for you guys who are preparing to face an interview for a combined police service, to be into the defense sector, to be into the security sector, this is what it means. So this matters more for you guys. That's why what I say, adversity quotient. How an individual behaves when you're put into pressure, when you are into a tight corner. How instant is your decision and how effective is your action following that? How you behave and function in a critical situation, put into a difficult situation, into pressure. So that matters more for people who, like you, aspire for a security sector, police services, to be specific. So along with your IQ, I don't undermine this. IQ matters a lot, but EQ and more than that, AQ, adversity quotient, will help you a lot. How you function and how you show up when you are put into pressure. So these both, AQ and EQ, will help us a lot. And this is especially a domain that we say soft skill domain. So that is what we'll focus on today. And especially this very session of being into a few interview tips. What I have decided is that I have divided into exactly two parts. One part will speak about for or how we prepare for an interview. And the second part is more important than that. It is how you behave. It is during an interview, at the interview, how is your performance? So both the segments are important. Let us begin with the first segment. That is when you prepare or when you are ready, getting ready for an interview. So let us see what's the reason. When you have been tested through your knowledge in written exams, so what matters there for an interview, for a face-to-face appearance? Why interviews are getting conducted, and what exactly the interviewers are looking forward. They want to see what sort of a personal you are, your personality and your attitude. That is what is seen when you face an interview. The second is how motivated you are, how passionate you are, and what is the level of enthusiasm inside you as far as the job or the duty or the work is concerned for which you are applying for. So this is what is being noted in specific. And of course, how will you express yourself? That's communication. Expression through your vocal, verbal skills, and more than that, through your attire, attitude, body language, or non-verbal communication. How will you stand? How will you look? How will you dress up? How will you show up your confidence? That is what matters. So these are specifically being looked into when you mean facing an interview or as far as interview tips or interview skills, interview facing skills are concerned. That is what I'm speaking of, the confidence code. The factor of confidence. You know where from this confidence comes? It's not much from your knowledge. Rather, it is the lot of exposure, the experience that you have. How well you understand the job that you are applying for? Who is your ideal? Whom are you feeling the people playing a major role in shaping yourself? How well you admire a police personnel and his duties? And how well you guess it, what are to be the work, the duty that you are going to pursue as a police personnel. So the whole lot or the much or the more of an experience that you are into will set your confidence level. That is what is noted there as far as your confidence in answering the questions, in appearing the board, in establishing yourself as the best matters. So that is what I mean, your confidence code. And next, there's another part to it, what I say, the why factor. We are born, it's all right. Whoever is born, excuse me if I say so, is to die one day. And if you join these 2 points, 2 dates, I call it a lifeline. Of course, the date of birth is very important for all of us. We celebrate it in many ways. But that is another day in a human being's life that is more important. Can you guess? Yes, it is a day, pray God, as far as practicable, the sooner it is the better, a person comes to realize the why factor. I mean, an answer to the question, ki why I exist, why I am born, what my parents expect out of me, what my teachers expect out of me, what my kids and kins, my neighbors, my society wants out of me. And of course, if I join an organization, I should very well understand what my organization wants to see within me. And specifically, if I call someone my boss, I should know what my boss wants me to perform, what he wants to see as a result if a job or a task being assigned to me. So it is the same for all. For a salesman, for a doctor, for an engineer, for a teacher like me, I should know why I am, for what I am for. And this why should be absolutely clear if you want to be successful in life. So that is what I call the why factor. If you know what you are for, if you know why you have applied for this job, if you know what you are going to perform as a police personnel, your why should be absolutely clear. That will set your confidence code very high. And you are going to come out as a winner. I know that. So that is the reason, I mean, why interviews are being called for and why you and me go for facing an interview. So overall, if you judge, it is your personality. The board is there to sense it. How good, how bold, how beautiful your personality is. You know, in Hindi we call it vyaktitva. Har vyakti ka ek vyaktitva hota hai. Even in a 3-year-old child, in everyone, agar ek vyakti hai, to uska ek vyaktitva hai. And you need to express it. Personality, I mean a successful personality. A leader-like personality. That is what we love to see. A person who is ready to take charge. A person who thinks that he is accountable for. A person who thinks that I am here to do a justice. A person who thinks that above all is the nation, is the society, is the people, and my duty, that is God. So that sort of a personality will be, of course, welcomed. And if I explain you, personality can be developed. Certain skills can be acquired that add value to your personality. So that is why we conduct sessions on personality development. If God permits, if God willing, we'll have it one day. And I'm one of the finest personality development trainers in the country. Okay. So you need to be, what I'm showing here, grooming your personality. Personality, think of this, there are two aspects to it, inner, outer. By inner personality, I again mean two aspects to that. Inside me is a body and a brain. So what I hint at is an individual should have a healthy body as well as a vibrant, sound and healthy, functional brain. I mean an intellect, an intellectual power to judge, to estimate, to take a decision. That's very important. So there are two aspects, if I say inner personality, good thoughts and a good body. Ek achhi sehat, achhi sharir, healthy and uske saath ek achhi aur sakaratmak soch, positive thoughts, good thoughts. That is very important. Taking into the second aspect, outer. When I look out to an outer personality, what I mean is, in a person there is something that I note can be done a makeup, manipulated. And there is something that cannot be manipulated. For example, what I mean, your height, your complexion, skin color, your hair. So this cannot be manipulated. But adding to that, there is another aspect, my dress code, my hairstyle, my beard style, the perfume that I use, the shoes that I wear, there are a lot that adds to my value, to my personality, but this can be manipulated. So personality is not just inner or outer. It's a combination, it's an integration of both inner and outer beauty that makes a wholesome personality. So we must be careful about grooming our personality from inside, outside, so that we'll be clicking. We can focus and we can come out successful in every individual that is in front of us. That is the beauty, what I mean personality is. One thing I am showing you here, do you see the footprints? Let me explain you in a different style, in Hindi if you follow it. Kadam aise chalo ke nishan ban jaye, pyar aise karo ke chahat ban jaye, kaam aise karo ke pehchan ban jaye, aur zindagi aise jiyo ke misal ban jaye. Of course, what I said, if I reiterate, kadam aise chalo ke nishan ban jaye. Leave your footprints so that the next generations will love to follow. Be a trendsetter. That's very important. That's a personality. Ki log aapki naqshe kadam pe chalna pasand kare. Pyar aise karo ke chahat ban jaye. Love your people in such a way that every individual will feel good to be with you, to be associated with you, to be in your segment, your department, your regiment, under your able leadership. Pyar aise karo ke chahat ban jaye. Har koi chahe, main aapke saath rahun. Kaam aise karo ke pehchan ban jaye. Do your work such that nobody can do it better. People will cite examples of yours. That is how it is to work. Aur zindagi aise jiyo ke misal ban jaye. Your life is going to set an example for others. People will quote you even if you are still there or not. Aapki jeevan ek biography bane jo dusron ko prerna de. People will be inspired from the lifestyle that is of yours. That is in true sense a great personality. And this matters a lot. Main nahi kehta, kitabon mein likha hai yaro, ye Gita gyan hai. Bhagwan Krishna kehte hain ki maa baap bahut koshish karte hain apni santanon ko ek achhe mukam pe pahunchane ke liye. सफलता के ओर प्रयास करता है हर कोई माँ बाप अपने बच्चों को लेके, पर यह भूल जाता है कि जैसी एक इंसान की व्यक्तित्व है, चरित्र है, उस हिसाब से उसकी सफलता होती है. सो द बेटर योर पर्सनालिटी इज, दैट इज गोइंग टू सेट योर हाइट ऑफ सक्सेस. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बी मोर सक्सेसफुल, इनहैंस योर पर्सनालिटी. अगर अपनी व्यक्तित्व से ज्यादा किसी को मिल भी जाता है ना, तो वो टिकता नहीं, या फिर टिका नहीं रहता, गिर जाता है, घट जाता है. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू अचीव मोर इन योर लाइफ इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट, फोकस ऑन डेवलपिंग योर पर्सनैलिटी. व्यक्तित्व ही सबसे बड़ी चीज है हर युग में, यह गीता का ज्ञान है. एंड वी हैव अ वीडियो. सो व्यक्तित्व बहुत बड़ी होती है, इट्स अ ग्रेट कंट्रीब्यूटिंग फैक्टर टू योर सक्सेस. आई टेल यू वन थिंग, यू मी एवरीवन मींस टू बी सक्सेसफुल, एम आई राइट? एवरीवन वांट्स टू क्लिक, दैट इज व्हाट आई मीन व्हेन आई से हियर CL. This CL, I mean success or click. Okay? And I give you a mantra to be successful. How it goes? It goes like this. Square root of T multiplied by F multiplied by C square gives you success. If you work out this equation on yourself, success is guaranteed. This T stands for time. And I make a square root of that because it doesn't matter much to me. It's your time, 24 hours at your disposal. Do anything you like. You can sleep, you can work out in a gym, you can study, or you can pass your time in a tea shop outside. Okay? So it is you and your time. How does it matter to anyone? That's why I'm getting a square root of that, because it makes very little meaning for the rest of the world. But that decides rather the way you use your 24 hours is defining what a personality you are. What's the value of your time? How much you judge yourself worth? So your time decides the way you use, invest, or waste. Your time is going to define your personality. Next comes F. That I see or mean is fit. How fit you are for the post, for the job you are applying for. If I say I look forward to be a salesman and I feel bad when a customer says no to me, so I don't suit. Somebody says, bada hokar main doctor banunga, I'll be a doctor when I grow up. But seeing a drop of blood, one faints. He becomes unconscious. So that never suits to a doctor, you know. A doctor is intended to be inside the OT conducting numerous operations. He never feels bad or afraid about seeing blood. So each one of us should see that what I'm aspiring for to be, whether I'm fit for that. If I am applying or aspiring to be into, like you guys are, to be a police personnel, to be into security sector or defense sector, I should be physically fit, bold, strong. That's it. So one has to be fit to be successful. And of course, the most important thing is the C here. The C, what I mean is your chemistry, Yes, that, what do you mean? That is what it is, the chemistry. What you are made up of. कहते हैं ना यार, किस मिट्टी का बने हो तुम? Yes, उस मिट्टी की बात करता हूं मैं. किस से बनी हो तुम? कितनी सॉलिड है तुम्हारी विल पावर, डिटर्मिनेशन? कितनी स्ट्रांग हो तुम व्हेन यू परस्यू अबाउट कि ये खेल तब खत्म होगा जब मैं जीत के उभर के आऊंगा. द गेम इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी ओवर टिल आई विन. दैट इज इट. एंड दिस केमिस्ट्री इंक्लूड्स एवरीथिंग. योर फिजिक, आई मीन योर बॉडी, योर ड्रेस, योर लुक्स, योर हेयर स्टाइल, योर वॉच, योर टाई, योर शूज, इवन द डियो दैट यू यूज, योर बॉडी ऑर्डर, एवरीथिंग मैटर्स. व्हेन आई से इट इज द केमिस्ट्री, दैट इज इट. एंड दैट इज पर्सनालिटी. एंड दैट इज स्क्वेयरली इंपॉर्टेंट, नॉट डबल. It is squarely important. So to be successful in life, personality matters a lot. So work on that. Work on that. Develop your personality so that you will be successful. That is what it is. So to be going into some specific things. Yes, it's well known what you and me say. It is the first impression. When you walk into, when you knock the door, when you ask, may I come in, sir? So when you enter the room, when you are facing the panel, your first impression, how you look, your personality overall from the outside, your dress code, your walking style, your standing posture, the way you wish the panel, the smile that you wear, the confidence that you reveal, that matters a lot. Because first impression is first impression. It cannot be done for a second time, in the second chance. That is the beauty. So for that, you dress appropriately. Many times I have faced this question. Even grown-up girls, married girls, they ask, sir, sari pehne ya dress? Sir, printed ya plain ya check? The only tips I give you, the only thing I'll reveal here, because I am not face-to-face with you, those stand in front of the mirror and look at yourself. Do you appear to be matured? Do you appear responsible? That's the point. So dress up accordingly so that you look grown up, you look matured, you look confident. That should be your dressing style. Nothing doing, thinking over it a lot. It is only to look matured, to look decent, to look professional. So get prepared, check it out, and settle down. Research the employer, the authority, the organization to which you want to join. Do a little bit work on that. Do a little bit research on that. What it is up to? What is their background? What is their credentials? What is their updated output? Because everybody will love to listen in appreciation. If you appreciate their endeavors, if you judge them well, if you can give better feedbacks, That will appear as if you're interested. You have a passion for that. And you know the job. Given the chance, day after tomorrow, you are ready to take over. That is what the board is looking forward. They're only searching for a personality they can rely upon to give the charge. And you are there to take over from there. So do a little bit of research about whatever organization you are going to appear. May it be the government, private, or whatever. Do a little bit exercise about the backdrop of the organization. What are the things they have to their credit that will be better helping you out when you face the panel and answer them? Know yourself. इससे पहले कि आप दुनिया को जान लो, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो योरसेल्फ, लुक इनसाइड योरसेल्फ. वॉट एवर इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बिकम सक्सेसफुल, गॉड हैज गिवन ऑल दोज फैक्टर्स इनसाइड यू ओनली. नो योरसेल्फ वेल, योर स्ट्रेंथ्स, योर वीकनेस, योर अपॉर्चुनिटीज, एंड व्हाट यू फील एज अ चैलेंज. यू शुड वेरी वेल नो योरसेल्फ. नेवर ओवर एस्टिमेट. That will make you overconfident. And never underestimate yourself so that you go low in your confidence. Judge yourself well. You is the best person who knows yourself. No one else. So know yourself well. And take care to note, if you can, go into it. Any challenges you have faced, the decisions and actions you have taken for that, and the results, C, A, and R. If you can narrate it, put it up in a proper manner within 1 to 2 minutes, 3 minutes, that will carry a lot of meaning. Because many often times I have heard people ask you, have you ever failed in any attempt? What are your learnings? So if you say always I am always successful, it may not be that impressive. But if you say that, yeah, I have attempted to resolve into such a challenge, and I decided and I worked up in it, and this is the result that I have received. So that will be more impressive. Evaluate the feelings. Map your future well. If you are aspiring to be into a job, you should know what's next. If you stay there, work well with sincerity, what will be your next step, next level, next higher position in the hierarchy? And basing upon your caliber, experience, expertise, your age, and all that, how far can you go? So map your future. Umeedon ke bagair zindagi ka koi matlab nahi hota. और जिसके पास उम्मीद ही ना हो वो इंसान काम क्या करेगा? अ लीडर हैज ए हाई एस्पिरेशन टू बी सक्सेसफुल. सो ईच ऑफ अस शुड हैव अ मैप, शुड हैव इन माइंड कि व्हाट्स नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट, हाउ फार कैन आई गो, दैट इज माय एस्पिरेशन. आई एम हियर टू जॉइन इन दिस पोजिशन, बट आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू स्टे हियर. आई विल बी ग्रोइंग इन दैट organization to the next higher levels. So you map your future, you should know it. Have questions prepared. What I mean, often they ask you, would you like to ask us any question? So you have 1 to 2 questions at your disposal. What do you want to learn or know more? So this needs a bit of homework. So you decide. If you fail to answer a question, if it is pertinent and relevant to that particular organization. So get prepared with that. Never forget to thank you. The way I said, the first impression when you enter, the way you wish the panel. People ask me, sir, whether I should go for namaskar or I'll wish them good morning. You know what matters? What matters is wishing. It's not namaskar or good morning. Both are the same. What matters is how you do it. It's not what. Good morning, your namaskar. If you say good morning, say it bold and say it beautiful, louder, clear, and give a look to the entire panel. It's not good morning, good morning, good morning. No, it's one good morning and giving a look to the entire panel members. And if you say namaskar, it's not a namaskar to each one of them. No, it's not like that. The more impressive is, hold it, namaskar, and give a look, give a smile at each of the panel members. That will carry more meaning. That is going to be more impressive. And similarly, when you bid a bye, goodbye, when you complete answering all the questions, when you are at your liberty to leave them, never forget to express your thanks, your gratefulness, your obligations. Do say that I'm grateful to this panel. Do say thanks a lot to all of you for being so nice to me. Dhanyavad dena bahut badi baat hai. So ye mat bhuliye aap. You should be aware that you express your thanks to the panel before you leave the board. That is it. Unless you complete it well, you are not that effective. The sender and the receiver should have a common understanding. If you feel that you are the best fit, the board should feel it, ki yeah, you are the best. So from the beginning to the end, that matters. That is what we say, an effective communication. Right? Let us move to the next. That is what I was saying. Know about the role, what you are going to perform. Do know what will be your designation, what is your profile, your remunerations, salary, and what is the growth path. You should be knowing that. It's not that you are lost. It's not that this is the post you are applying for. And you deserve more than the best. You deserve more than that what you aspire for. So you should be knowing for what you are appearing for. You should know about the role, the responsibilities, the duties that you are going to perform or you are supposed to do as a police personnel or as an entry post that you are applying or getting into. Next. It's a beautiful saying here, to be professional. You know what do you mean by professional? Professional is to be accountable for. Your word and your work should match. What you say, the people should get it the same. So rule of 12, that's what they say. You can note it. So for this, what I mean is a professional approach. What do you mean by a professional? A professional is a person who feels himself accountable for. Your word should match with your work. That is it. So how to impress upon as far as a professional or professional approach is concerned? What's that they say is the rule of 12. You can note it. That's what they say. The first 12 words. The first 12 steps, the first 12 inches, and the last 12 inches. The first 12 words is what comes out of my mouth when I meet a person. The very first words, I mean the first 12 words, should be very much focused, specific, and meaningful. It's not to be doing a mesh. It's not going for a gossip. A professional person always means what he says. So be specific and be focused when you speak something. The first 12 steps, when you approach or when you enter, you have to be very much calculative and noble as far as your steps is concerned. It's not walking in a very haphazard manner. You work like a noble personality, like a fine personality. Your steps need to be calculated, very gentle. The first 12 inches, I mean your face, starting from your hairstyle to your chin. This has to be very neat, presentable, and decent, so that one loves to look at you, to see you, to talk to you. That is very important. And the last 12 inches, what I mean is below my knees to my shoes. Let me focus on that. A neat pair of shoes or footwear is very much essential for a professional. So when you go to an interview, be very careful to choose a very formal pair of shoes that suits to your personality. That is very important. So look forward to note the rules of 12 to create a very wonderful professional impression on the panel when you meet them. 1,000 times more important is the unspoken language, is the non-verbal communication apart from your verbal communication. So that is it. What we do or what we say is not that important, but more important is how we look, how we say it. It is not what, it is how that is important. Non-verbal skills. So work on that unspoken language. It's not important to answer all the 5 questions. It's not customary that an individual, a candidate, is obvious or expected to know answer to all my questions. Even if you do not know the answer to a question, how you take it, that matters. How you appear, how you give a smile, or how you take, or how you appear to be submissive when you say, "Can I get the next question, sir?" I do not exactly remember right now. So how noble, how gentle are you, how submissive are you when you are not able to answer a single question? It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if you do not answer 4 out of 5. Or if you answer the last question right and in an impressive manner, enough. So it is not to get into panic or get afraid of, get nervous of, "Okay, I'm unable to answer 4 questions. What will be for the next?" A single question ka answer agar aap sahi de paate ho na, sir, wonderful. That will be enough to get into it, to select you. So don't worry. Even if you do not know, even if you get a counter question, even if you see the panel is not agreeing to your statements, it's not to argue on that. It's not to be stubborn and rigid on that. That is what I said, your AQ, adversity quotient. Because they are very seniors, they are very experienced ones, very knowledgeable ones in front of you. So it's better to accept, to adapt. So that doesn't mean that I'll say you agree on whatever they say, even if they say a day is a night. No, it's not that. If they say that sun rises in the west, no, it's not that. If you know something very seriously and very sincerely, very correctly, be yourself. Be yourself. Agreed. But in controversial things, it's better to adapt, to be submissive, and to look forward to the next question or the next personality to give you or ask you a question. So it is how you answer, how you look, it's not what you answer. So it is the unspoken language, it is the body language that matters, not your skills. Okay? This is what I mean when I said, ki look into your personality and personal grooming habits. The outer looks of yours. Look at this. Your hair, your nails, your teeth, your makeup. Be careful. And specifically, I'll ask you about your accessories. So as far as this slide is concerned, take care of your personal grooming habits. This is what I said. When I look at you, at the outer personality aspect, this is what it is. Your hairstyle, your nails, your teeth, your uniform, your makeup. So take care as regards to all that. It should appear impressive to the board. That is it. And especially, if I ask you, differentiating, if you are a male candidate, if you are a male candidate, then limit yourself into 3 accessories, not more than that. If you have a watch, a tie, and a belt, done. Not more than that. It's not to have 10 rings in 10 fingers. No. That will carry a negative impression of yours. And if it is a girl child, a female candidate, I'll ask you be careful about limiting it to your limits. 5 maximum. Because girls, they have earrings, maybe bangles, maybe a necklace. So max to max, it is 5 for a female candidate, as far as accessories are concerned. So apart from your dress code, your hairstyle, your personal grooming habits, focus on your accessories that you wear on. So be very professional when you enter and face an interview board or a panel. Know yourself, I said. Be very careful about your strength, your weakness, the opportunities that you have, and of course, the challenges. And those are to be related to the job. And of course, if you speak something, have collaterals to prove it, to justify your statements, how they were developed. You should be knowing that. Identify your role models. And similarly, your areas of improvement. If they ask you, what are your weaknesses? So it is to speak about your weakness as if they feel it. These are adding to your personality. These are values or virtues of yours. So be very careful when you list it out. There is time. Work on that. And be very careful about enlisting those and getting ready for the interview. This can be customized time and again for different aspects, for different jobs, different organizations, at different times. So every individual should know himself or herself first. You should know, rather I should know, what are my strengths and where I am weak. What are the opportunities in front? And what real challenges that I feel to be coming in the way? And you know, 2 aspects to it. When you communicate, knowing your SWOT, 2 aspects to that. If you work on that well, it clicks. Something I called intention, and something is called a presentation. Intention and presentation. Let me explain you in this way. You know, intention is something that is inside. But presentation can be seen. it is for the rest in the globe. This is how the saying goes, whatever or how good may be your intention, but the people around, the world is looking forward to see your presentation. Reverse, maybe how excellent your presentation is, but God is looking forward, rather looking within at your intentions. How good are they? So for a person to click, rather for a fine personality, both intention and presentations are to match. What you think within and what you speak should match. That is the beauty. So we need to work on ourselves a little bit so that we can create the best impression on the board or panel and come out as a winner. As I said, ki EQ and AQ, emotional intelligence, emotional quotient, and adversity quotient, are the soft skill domains. Let me specifically lay down before you a few more that will be explaining you well your communication skills, writing skills, your body language, how you present yourself. Are you a team player? How good a leader are you? That is what I said right now. What excellent or beautiful or bold your personality is. And as far as people management skills are concerned, relationship management skills are concerned, and specifically IPR skills, interpersonal relationship skills, because you are not alone any further. You are going to be inducted into an organization and working in a team spirit with others, in a department, under your boss, under a leader, or being assigned upon, you become the leader and lead a regiment, a troop, a group of people. So you need to be having better interpersonal relationship skills. As a leader, you have to be decisive. So how good are you in decision making? We talked a lot about self-confidence. Of course, when you get inducted, go into your work, complete one after another the assignments assigned to you, you will gain more and more confidence to be into the field. And of course, last but not the least, your time and stress management exercises. How you take care to manage your time and manage yourself as far as stress is concerned. Because you cannot avoid. The more skilled you show, the more experienced you are, the more you go higher in the ladder in the organization, what do you think? Yes, you will be given tougher and tougher assignments. So what then? You should be showing off then also with proper time and stress management. People talk a lot over the whole world about work-life balance. And rather, I'll salute police personnel on that what we see during this pandemic period, the corona crisis, COVID-19 phase. How stressed are they? How bold are they, and how committed are they to serve the nation? So we need to learn from that and get into their footsteps to follow them and grow in the ladder. That is it. Acquiring personal skills. I'm leaving it to you only. Where you are excellent, where you are average, in which aspect you need to grow and manage yourself. So work it out before you go to the board. You have to be assertive. You deal with your stress. And you know how you relax, what are the techniques. Right? That is it. Time management, personal development, emotional intelligence, personal presentation skills, self-motivation. Leaders are self-motivated people. They need no one to motivate them. Their work, their target motivates themselves. Building confidence, self-esteem. How you rate yourself, how you see yourself, how you measure yourself. That is what matters. And personal appearance. How tall you stand, whatever is the occasion. And especially for this occasion, for this purpose, for you guys, for this segment of warriors, police personnel, security personnel, I love their dress code. I love their dress code. So work on that, how you appear, how you shoot, because you have time to grow your personality further, 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 matching to the expectations of the board. How you are ready to deal with an aggression, that is going to be life. Warna zindagi mein maza nahi hai. That is truly what you say, life. It's not meant to be going very smooth. Life is full of ups and downs. So love it, face it, and come out successful. Work for the people. Let the whole world identify you by your work. So with that sort of a mentality or mindset, get yourself ready, because your things are to be set on that very day when you are in front of the panel. When Lord Krishna narrated the entire thing before Arjuna, still then the things are not over. It is a soap in the real war field. Back at work, when you are on that very room in front of the panel, that is where you are going to show up what you are. Get ready for that. Let me say you all this. Agar Gopal banoge to gaay milega. Agar Gopal banoge to gaay milega. Agar Garud chahiye to Vishnu banna avashyak hai. Gopal ko kabhi Garud nahi mila. Being the same characters, look at the personality. So work on yourself. You have the chance, you are the best, and you know yourself the well. You know yourself, only you know yourself. That it means. Aap jano, aapki Bhagwan jane. So look inside. Find out your weaknesses, work out on your personality, and I can guarantee if you grow your personality well, you can very well face the situations that will be coming up in the interview board. Right? Let me end this session saying, practice makes us better. So keep practicing, keep practicing, stay tuned, connect with your mentors, connect with your role models, do take lessons and experience from them, work on yourself. You are the best. You are going to click. Wait and watch. Look forward for the second part of the session that is more important. I'll give you some demos. How to enter, how to take the chair, how to behave in front of the panel, and the more important aspects of non-verbal communication. So that part, the second part, is going to be more important, more interesting. So get ready for the second part. Good luck. Stay tuned.